Welcome back to another Behavior Breakdown. Most of you already know, but for those who don't, I'm a marine biologist with over a decade's worth of experience working with a variety of marine mammals, including sea otters. And marine mammal behavior is kind of my thing. All right, let's hit play and dive back into munching on a fresh crab and sharing with baby. With over 10 million views, it is one of the most viral videos on YouTube. I, of course, have the most viral videos on TikTok. Okay, I don't know about sharing. Mom seems to be really enjoying her snack. Okay, so what happens here? No, mom's like, nah, this is mine. Okay, so there's some unintentional sharing. the pup definitely wants some snacks, but this is mom trying to keep the crab for herself. Okay, so I can very clearly see that mom is still nursing. So this pup is not fully transitioned from milk to solid foods yet. She's very obviously interested in those solid foods though, but certainly not ready to be out on her own in the ocean. I don't know if the pup actually got any crab out of this. Mom decided for whatever reason that she needed this more than the pup did. And nursing sea otter mothers definitely need a lot of nutrition. It's possible that the mom recognizes that maybe a crab isn't the best source of food for a young growing pup to start out with. This is not an abalone or a clam. Crabs, fight back. Mom is also making quick work of this crab, just tearing into it. That might be due in part to the pup trying to get at it and mom wanting to make sure she disposes of it as quickly as possible. Now don't get me wrong, sea otter moms absolutely will share their food and do, but that doesn't look like what's going on here. But otters have these extremely dexterous paws you can see her using here. They have semi-retractable claws on those paws, and that really allows them to rip, tear, pull apart these crustaceans. They're also incredibly strong animals. Sometimes mother pups will actually break down the food for their pups, really sort of cracking into the items for them to make it a little bit easier on their young tummies. It's honestly a pretty interesting dynamic. Sea otter moms, and really all moms actually, have to ride a really fine line where they need to make sure that they sustain themselves while also sustaining a pup. Sea otters need to eat about a quarter of their body weight every single day, and that is a lot of food. But imagine then having to take care of a pup in addition to that. So it's a lot more than a quarter of her body weight that she needs to find every single day. But let's talk about sea otter moms and pups for a second. Sea otter pups are completely dependent on their mothers for 6 to 8 months typically. The pup can't even dive for a period of several weeks after being born. And that is mostly due to the fact that sea otter pups have a different type of coat than their adult counterparts. It's called a lanugo, and it acts a little bit like a sea otter life preserver. It quite literally prevents them from diving below the surface of the water, instead having them bob at the surface like a little sea otter cork. They'll start shedding that lanugo at around 2 months of age or so, but even after that, diving takes a bit of practice. So moms will spend a lot of time tending their pups on their bellies. They can use that area to groom the pup, nurse the pup, even start to feed it some solid foods. But of course, mom still has to forage for food. So how does she manage that with a pup that cannot come along with her? Well, sea otters are incredibly resourceful. They are one of the few animals in the world known to use tools. And one of those tools they'll use lives right in their home, the kelp forest. They can use the kelp fronds like you can actually see here in the video. The mother will wrap the frond around her pup, acting a little bit like a sea otter seatbelt. That way the pup floats in one area at the surface, and when mom comes back up, she knows exactly where to find him. Or her, in this case. Sea otter moms are some of the best moms on the planet, with the exception of my mom. Shut up. Male sea otters, on the other hand, are bachelors for life. They can even make a mother sea otter's life very difficult by trying to steal the pup and coerce the mom to trade it for all the snacks that she just worked really hard for. This is a slightly older pup. Her fur still looks pretty juvenile, but it's definitely started to shed some of that lanugo characteristic. The fur also needs a little bit of work, so I imagine that mom is still helping to groom this pup. The pup does not seem to be doing a very good job of it by herself. It's not in the best condition, or at the very least, she's not doing a good job of grooming, and I would know. After all, I did have to teach a sea otter named Taslina how to groom.
We have to groom you.
So adding everything up, the lanugo, the quality of the fur, the fact that mom is still nursing, tells me that this is definitely still a dependent pup. It's really hard to tell from the video, but based on her size and the quality of her coat, she looks a little younger. This pup, which is a female pup, in case you care, I would say that she's probably a little around 3 months old. It's a really beautiful video with a lot of interesting things happening. Did you see something I missed? Or have a question about anything? Let me know down in the comments. Or head over to my Twitch channel, you can ask me live. Cheers. Some of you might actually recognize this clip. We did use this clip in our last behavior breakdown video. You can find a link to that here. Is it right or left hand?
Right hand.
Can we move it? And marine mammal behavior is kind of my thing, so this video drops squarely in my wheelhouse. I was gonna say roundhouse, then I was gonna have to kick the camera, that was gonna be...